watching Beyond with me, Aisha Sindhu. We've got all the latest from India coming up in the next half hour. First up, let's take a look at our top stories. As India reconsiders Pakistan's most favored nation status, Prime Minister Modi boycotts SAARC summit in Islamabad. Trade experts say Pakistan industry will be hit hard if India chooses to withdraw its most favored nation status. Ahead of the Indus Treaty review meet in India, Pakistan makes a preemptive move, approaches the World Bank and International Court of Justice on the issue. Karnataka's government calls an emergency cabinet meeting today to discuss the ongoing Kaveri dispute. And some big news from the world of cricket. The Lodha Committee submits its status report to the Supreme Court, demands removal of BCCI top bosses, including Chief Anurag Thakur. Right, that big story first up. The Lodha Committee has submitted its status report to India's Supreme Court. Panel in its report has said that the BCCI is not implementing its recommendations. In fact, the measures it has recommended for improving functions of the BCCI. The panel pleaded to the Chief Justice of India for an early hearing. The Justice Lodha Committee has also moved the Supreme Court seeking removal of the BCCI President Anurag Thakur as well as the board secretary on grounds that they are not letting implementation of court-appointed committees' recommendations. In fact, my colleague... All right, let's talk a little bit more about that big story. Joining me in our studio live right now is WEON's chief domestic correspondent, Kartikeya Sharma, as well as senior sports journalist, Malay Nirav. Thank you both for joining us here. Malay, I'll come to you first. Can you put this entire thing in perspective for our viewers, for those of us who are just still sort of catching up on this tussle between the BCCI and the Lodha Committee?
Well, Lodha Committee was formed after the orders of the Supreme Court of India, and they gave their recommendations. On July the 18th of this year, the committee's recommendations were ratified by the Supreme Court, and then the BCCI was expected to follow the recommendations that Lodha Committee had made and that Supreme Court had ratified. After that, you know, they were expected to follow certain the recommendations were made by Lodha Committee, which were made by Lodha Committee. They were expected to follow and implement those recommendations. But somehow or other, there was a sense of a defiance which prevailed in the BCCI. And Justice Lodha apparently has moved the Supreme Court, because the Supreme Court had said that if there were any problems in implementing the committee's recommendations, Justice Lodha and his members, co-members of the committee, could come back to the Supreme Court. So that's how they have gone to the Supreme Court and said in very clear terms that impediments are being caused by the BCCI, which has not followed what they promised they would. They gave assurances saying that they would follow the Lodha Committee recommendations, implement them, but they haven't done it. They have been dilly-dallying. They have filed a review, but more than that, subject to the review and modifications, if at all there are some suggested by the Supreme Court, what has happened now is that there's a kind of a defiance, which is not so open, but in more than one ways, you know, the BCCI has taken its own route,
right,
and ignored the recommendations of the Lodha Committee, which is a very serious matter, because, you know, it is one of those things where Supreme Court has mandated, that whatever Lodha committee has said has to be implemented, and they are not doing it. And more than that, what they have done is that they have gone ahead with their own line of action, and which is not in tune with the recommendations. For example, the latest, that on the 30th of September, they have called a general body meeting, whereas they had assured that on the 28th of September, there will be an executive general body meeting, which general meeting, EGM, where they would adopt the recommendations of Lodha committee. So this defiance has invited very, very indicting remarks from the Supreme Court today, and they have been asked to reply to the petition made by Justice Lodha in the first week of October, by the 6th of October, I guess.
All right. So we're also joined right now by former Indian cricketer, Mr. Surinder Khanna. Mr. Khanna, let's have your initial reaction to the latest in this tussle between the BCCI and the Justice Lodha Committee.
To be honest, Supreme Court is the highest court of the country, very respectable, and they had formed a Lodha Committee. And they had certain recommendations for the BCCI to follow. They had given them time, enough time, but the defiance from the BCCI top brass has probably brought them to the brink where Subroto Shiri Sahara is. This is the highest court of the country. The law of the land has to prevail, but the BCCI hukmaran probably feel they are from a different planet. And these recommendations and rules of the law of the land doesn't apply to them. So I think they have to face the consequences for defiance and not implementing what Lodha Commission and Supreme Court has told them to do.
Right.
And it's high time they are put in their places.
Karthikeya, BCCI playing with fire there as far as ignoring, really speaking, the recommendations made by a panel that has been formed by, really speaking, the highest court of this country.
See, there are two things. One is the reform of BCCI. The second is the reform of the sporting bodies. And the third is the sort of incestuous relationship which exists between sporting bodies and politicians cutting across parties. Now, what is a BCCI? It's not a dinosaur. BCCI is a private club of the most powerful politicians in this country. So, you know, you can have Sharad Pawar, you can have Farooq Abdullah, you can have Jyotiraditya Scindia. At one point of time, Arun Jaitley was there. You have Rajiv Shukla. All of them associated with political structures. And the collective strength they get is the reason why they're able to take on judiciary as well. So it also goes on to show that there is lack of will and the ability of politicians through BCCI to manipulate laws. In the second term of UPA, Ajay Makan wanted to build a bill, sports bill. He could not get the bill passed. His successor, Jiten Singh, could not get the bill passed. His successor in Bharatiya Janata Party, now the chief minister of Assam, Mr. Sonowal, couldn't get the bill passed. And you have the fourth sports minister sitting on the model code of conduct bill, but it had not seen the light of the day. Why? Because the provision was that there has to be an RTI, sporting bodies must have age limits, there has to be criteria for elections, number of times they should fight elections, but none of those things happened.
Right.
So it begets a question. Congress was in power at that point of time. They didn't do it. Now the BJP is in power. Still, nothing is happening, and you have BCCI, as he was explaining, which is charting its own course of action as if it exists in a vacuum independent of laws of this country. The reason is that politicians have this unholy alliance with BCCI.
Malay, do you agree with that? Do you think
absolutely,
it is an
incestuous relationship? Let me take it a little further.
Sure.
You see, when the sports bill was being drafted and it went to the cabinet, that was a UPA regime in power, but there were people from across the political parties who were there, including the present president of the BJP. He was also holding a position. The prime minister was also holding a position in the Gujarat Cricket Association. Now, that was a time when the stiffest opposition came from the cricket bodies, led by Sharad Pawar and Rajiv Shukla, both of whom were part of the Indian cabinet.
Right.
After that, you know, there was a lot of problem, a lot of deliberations. They wanted to just dilute the bill. They did try to do that. But because of the opposition, and there was one single point, which was the most sticky point, where the BCCI didn't want to stick its neck out, and that was that RTI, right? Mm-hmm. Falling within the gambit of the RTI, which was opposed. Now, in hindsight today, let me tell you, the BCCI must be thinking that it would have been better to accept the Sports Act than to just go in for implementing Lodha Committee recommendations, because these are harsher than the Sports Act, perhaps. But I fully agree with Karthikeya when he says that all the politicians, regardless of their political ideologies, are hand in gloves, and it is a kind of a mutual admiration club, yes, where members of the cozy club just have been scratching each other's back and trying to avoid every such intervention, whether it is the judiciary or whether it is someone else. Now, they have, I think, gone a bit too far with the Supreme Court, and that is where they should be willing to face the brunt. But let me tell you another thing, that today the defiance is still very much there. Now, Sharad Pawar, today I heard him saying that Lodha Committee doesn't know what it's doing, because let's make our viewers listen into that.
We've actually got Mr. Pawar's reaction to that latest submission of that report by the Lodha Committee to the Supreme Court. Let's listen into what Mr. Pawar, who, by the way, is the head of the Maharashtra Cricket Association. Let's listen in.
We want some guidance from them, because in Supreme Court judgment, categorically mentioned, whatever decision which we are taking will not affect the state associations and their constitution. So that Supreme Court has said, that's why we are just requested to clarify this, because if we have to call a general meeting, AGM, and make a changes in constitution, we have no objection.
Let's go across to Mr. Khanna. Mr. Khanna, we just heard the MCA chief, Mr. Sharad Pawar, speaking on that latest development in the Supreme Court. Now, he's saying that he's only requesting time and guidance on understanding further. I'll quickly update you on that. He basically said that the MCA and other state associations...
Listen, I'll tell you one thing. Yeah, I heard from you what he was saying.
Go ahead.
I'll tell you one thing. Politicians have a way of twisting the words. But they forget in the end that this is the highest court of the country. If today BCCI is in defiance, and tomorrow you and me can also come in defiance that BCCI didn't accept Supreme Court's recommendations and order, we will not do it. Every citizen of the country will stand up and start doing that. The law of the land has to prevail. This is the Honorable Supreme Court's judgment and a panel formed by them. And they have done exemplary work for over 2 years, 1.5 years. And BCCI had enough time, the administrators over there, they completely ignored and didn't abide by the regulations, the recommendations, and now they have to face the music. Like Subroto Saharashiri, the law of the land has to prevail.
Right.
And these people just took it for granted, like they are from a different planet. They don't belong to you and me crowd that we accept the court's regulations. They feel they are above the law of the land because they are sitting in the parliament, or they are ministers, or they are in high positions, or they are high industrialists.
Right, Mr. Khanna, I'm going to interrupt you there. We're going to get in an opinion.
And they should go where Subroto Shiri is.
Right.
You see, it's like a cartelization. You have to basically study that whole architecture, the edifice. You know, you have Amit Shah, as he pointed out, Narendra Modi. All have been at the state levels, have been the chiefs of the cricketing body. So anyone who gets to be powerful politically first controls the state body, find himself in the sporting club. And often we have seen that it is also reflecting dynastic colors. So after Madhavrao Scindia, even Jyotiraditya Scindia finds a place in BCCI. So BCCI is not only a sort of an unholy alliance, it is showing dynastic characters whereby certain people are getting entry. And secondly, the biggest corruption scandals in cricket has taken place under BCCI. Mm-hmm. Different scapegoats have been found. Some are absconding this country. But the body which fathered that scandal, none were brought in front of the law. None of them. and most of them continued with their political career, and some even went on to control them. And the same IPL continues in multiple avatars, but none of the members of the BCCI, except one, were taken to the task. So I think what is really required is parliamentary scrutiny. Court has done the job. Court has delivered a verdict. I think the government needs to show political stamina by at least introducing a bill, or introducing a bill which is in line or in continuity with what has been observed by the court.
Malay, yeah. Do you agree? Do you think that is the way to go forward? Have the parliament sort of take an active role in these recommendations
The legislation has to come through the parliament. Undoubtedly, that is true. But at the same time, let me also tell you this, that the Supreme Court is not going to take it very kindly that you are challenging the Supreme Court's appointed body, the body which is headed by a former Chief Justice of India, and you are entering into some kind of a harakiri by taking opinion of another Chief Justice, former Chief Justice, bringing it in and then asking for a review. All that is fine. You just get it reviewed. Nobody's stopping you from the review. But at the same time, the recommendations have been made, and there's an order of the Supreme Court. It's very much like the Kaveri waters. When the Supreme Court has ordered, you have to implement it. You just can't dilly-dally. They have been dilly-dallying. You see, what they're, and there you can smell more than a rat. You see, there is the view of Kartikeya, and which is true, that they must be trying to keep their control. They're like, they're behaving like feudal lords. And this is what the Supreme Court has said, that you are behaving like lords. You think you are above the land of law of the land. No, that is one thing. So before the legislation is passed, I think the Supreme Court will make life unbearable for them. Just take it, they should not be mistaken. Now, it is high time that they stop all this harakiri, as I said, and they implement whatever has been implemented, what has been
suggested.
Now, you know, over the last few weeks, you might have seen in the newspapers one or two very eminent cricketers speaking on behalf of the BCCI, pleading for this. Now, Mr. Pawar himself is 75. If the regulations are implemented, he'll lose his position as the president of the MCA. So now he's saying state associations were not to be affected by these regulations. It is absolutely wrong to say this. They're just trying to find a lame excuse to remain comfortably seated in those positions of power whereby they think that they'll be able to control perhaps the biggest purse in India that
right.
anybody can and control.
And it happens, and it tells a story. The story is that why courts are in. The courts are in because the politicians have failed to do the job.
Mm-hmm.
Why you use the word Kaveri. Why has Kaveri become sub judice? Because the arbitration set by Narasimha Rao was not allowed to function. So when politicians don't do their job, the courts jump in. Even in this case, it was the responsibility of Parliament of India to pass the law. So when the law was not passed, as he correctly mentioned, the courts came in.
Right.
So the failure at the political level takes place. And secondly, the most important part is what makes BCCI so precious? Obviously, people will say money.
Money.
But it's money.
And power.
Which is unaudited.
Right.
You have money which is unaudited. You have perks which are unaudited because it's the only private body in the world which controls the national team.
Right. We actually have a very interesting conversation that my colleague Molly Gambhir had a little earlier with Justice Lodha. Let's listen in and get a bit more perspective on this conversation we're having right now.
Cutting across to Justice R.M. Lodha himself, who's joining us on the broadcast right here at Beyond. Thanks very much, sir, for speaking with us. You have come down heavily, sir, on the BCCI's top brass for failing to implement the recommendations given out to you. What a message, sir, do you think this failure to implement your recommendations really gives out?
Thank you. The Supreme Court gave us twin tasks, one to draw timelines for implementation of the recommendations and to supervise the implementation. We accordingly had drawn timelines, handed it over to BCCI, and thought that they will abide by that. Since they were holding AGM meeting on 21st July, we issued direction to them to conduct only routine business and do and make decisions pertaining to 2015-16. But we found that they took certain decisions which were directly in conflict with the recommendations which have been accepted by the Supreme Court. There being violations, we were given liberty by the Supreme Court that should there be any impediment in implementation of the recommendations, a status report will be submitted for appropriate direction. We followed that route. We have submitted the status report, brought to the notice of the Supreme Court the violations of the committee's directives and the Supreme Court judgment and the committee's report. And now it is for the Supreme Court to take a decision on that.
Mr. Khanna, we're talking about this unholy alliance, as Kartikeya called it, this mix and nexus of power, money that is in operation as far as the BCCI and cricket goes in the country. You've been a very integral part of the sport. Tell us how much of this rot affects really what we're forgetting about at the end of the day, which is the sport of cricket, which has so many impassioned fans and followers across South Asia.
I think you've seen our debacle in the Olympics. We don't have a sports law like my friend Malay was talking about and Kartike. And it will never happen if we have the same sort of politicians in the parliament. You got to have the will to do something good for the society, for the country. They only have that vision where you call that myopia, I, me, myself. Because there was law in England, the Pakistani captain and two of the cricketers were jailed for fixing. In India, we have seen fixing happening and people taken to courts, but since there is no law, they just go scot-free. So it's the will which counts in the parliament. And in BCCI, this unholy alliance has defied the highest court of the country. The law of the land has to prevail. They all know that. This is one body and sports bodies where you are not accountable for spending, siphoning, and doing whatever you want. So first time they were all made, these private bodies, into public servants. They are performing public functions because these games are followed by millions of Indians who go to the ground, pay money, and that money comes into the coffers of the BCCI and other sporting federations, and then they siphon off that money. That's how Supreme Court came into action, and the panel was formed, and they gave recommendations. They wanted to set BCCI in order, and then other sports federations also.
Right.
But the politicians have a habit of defying because they feel they are from a different planet. They are not answerable to anybody. They are a law to themselves. So
right.
This time probably they have gone too far, and now their place should be somewhere where Subroto Shri Sahara is.
Right, Kartikeya, we're looking at some of those recommendations, and the structural changes that the committee has called for may include the rolling of some very important heads, including Mr. Anurag Thakur. How exactly do you see the BCCI now responding going forward?
See, politically, I see there's a confrontation. You know, I don't think BCCI is going to give in very easily. Anurag Thakur is not Anurag Thakur. He's Prem Kumar Dhumal's son, former Chief Minister of Himachal Pradesh, someone who's close to Mr. Jaitley. So Anurag Thakur is not Anurag Thakur. He's also a guy who headed the frontal organization of RSS, three-time MP from Bharati Janata Party. So Anurag Thakur is not Anurag Thakur. Rajiv Shukla is not Rajiv Shukla. Rajiv Shukla is a third-time MP, a former journalist. He has his hands full, a guy who very close to Ahmed Patel and did all the odd jobs when the parliament was in session. So my point is that yes, judiciary has taken on BCCI, but it has taken a club of very powerful individuals like Jyotiraditya Scindia. You just look at the people who control state bodies and account them in the parliament, account them in terms of the economic and political heft they are control of. And then you'll find even the tallest body like an apex court, supremely intellectual and supreme when it comes to deciding things. BCCI and the people who control it still have the heft to prolong the matter now.
Right, Malay, we're running out of time, so very quickly your closing comments on this entire debacle.
Well, they'll try their best to delay it, to prolong it, but I think that the time has come when they must wind up all this harakiri. They have to listen to the Supreme Court They must implement it. And don't forget that within the BCCI, there are people who want to become president and treasurer and secretary, and who would be very happy if those who are firmly seated, they vacate the seats for them. So, and also, please also don't forget that these places could be controlled by pawns in the hands of these big names that we have just taken. So it is not going to end overnight, but yes, a major, major reform is in the offing. Let's accept it.
All right. So clearly it comes down to this, that the BCCI may have bitten off more than it can chew. It's taken on the most powerful court of the country. And of course, we can expect some heads to roll in the weeks going forward. On that note, we're going to wrap up this special discussion. Malay, thank you so much for joining us in the studio. Karthikeya, as always, a pleasure having you here. And of course, Mr. Surinder Khanna, thanks so much for joining us with your inputs and updates on that story. We appreciate your time. I'm Aisha Sindhu. You were watching us on this special discussion on the Lodha Committee's recommendations as far as the BCCI goes and the Supreme Court coming down hard on India's cricket body. Thanks so much for tuning in on this special show. We will be back with more news and updates on the other side of this break. Thanks so much for joining us.